You know why I pulled you over this morning?
Well, I'm pretty sure I wasn't speeding. I've been using the cruise control, so I don't...
No, sir. Your windshield. License and registration, please.
Right. This was from Wayfarer 515. My house was in the debris field. And that's what shattered my windshield, some piece of wreckage from the plane.
I understand.
You know of Flight 515, the plane crash? You're wearing the ribbon?
Yes, sir, I'm quite aware of Wayfarer 515. I was one of the first responders on the scene that day.
Then what are you doing?
Citing you, sir.
What? What, you don't believe me?
Sir, regardless of how that windshield was damaged, this car is unsafe to drive in this condition. Stay in the car, please.
Wait, just a minute. Just one minute.
Sir, I ask you to stay in the vehicle.
No. I can get out of my own car.
Sir, listen.
No. You listen to me. It's time for you to listen to me.
Sir, what you need to do is take a deep breath.
This is America,
okay? Get back in that car
right
now.
Do you understand that? At least have the common decency to hear me out.
I need you to step back right now.
Did you even hear what I said?
Sir, calm
down. Now you're giving me a ticket? I told you that my house was in the debris field. You have the remotest inkling of what that means.
Sir, calm down.
Hellfire rained down on my house where my children sleep.
Sir, I need you to step back. I need you to step back right now.
There were body parts in my yard.
Sir, this is your last warning.
You gotta be kidding me.
You got about 2 seconds to stand down or I'm gonna pepper spray you.
Oh, you're gonna pepper spray?
You understand that?
That is just perfect. Pepper spray the man who's expressing his opinion under the First Amendment.